We have some breaking news, and it comes out of the state of Kansas, where ABC News is projecting a winner in the very, very competitive and hotly contested race there. And it is the Republican, Pat Roberts, who is, we are projecting, going to be the independent Greg Orman. Greg Orman, many people thought, was going potentially to unseat this long-serving Republican senator. So let's get it out to Kansas City right now and ABC News correspondent Matt Gutman. Matt, this has to be a surprise to a lot of people given the surge that we've seen for a while, the wind beneath the wings of Greg Orman.
Greg Orman nearly had it up until just a couple of days ago, Dan. He was leading in the polls, but the Republican establishment threw in everything they had over the past couple of weeks to try to snatch victory from the jaws of defeat here, and it was very, very close. They had a lot of big guns rolling out here, including Bob Dole, a lot of other national figures in the Republican Party, and it appeared to have worked. Another thing that appeared to have worked for the Republicans, and this is Pat Roberts' fourth term. He will be 84 when he finishes his fourth term in the Senate. Another thing that worked for them, ground game. Greg Orman was an unknown. He was a businessman. He had done very well for himself, but he had no ground game. They spent a lot of money on advertising. He doubled the amount of TV ads that Pat Roberts had. It still didn't work. Now, just to give you a sense of how big and how important this race ended up becoming, because previously, Pat Roberts had been doing this alone. He basically had been running unopposed. But he was so surprised by this, but that just in the past couple of months, outsiders spent $17 million on advertisements here in Kansas on that Senate race. In 2008, how much was spent? $400,000. So this was vitally important for the Republicans. They played for keeps and they got it.
Yeah, he was really fighting from behind. There were these disclosures that, in fact, he was mostly living in Washington, D.C., and that when he came back to his alleged home state, he was staying with friends, that he didn't really have a primary residence there. And then after fending off a Tea Party challenge in the primary, there were reports that his campaign was so disorganized they didn't even have Wi-Fi in the office. How exactly, who came in and saved it?
National Republican strategists came in to save it. People who had worked with President Bush, people who had worked very closely with Karl Rove, they came in and headed up the strategy here, and they said, we're going to call the shots. This is how it's going to be run. And by the way, it was run in a very, very tough manner, you could say. Those advertisements, by and large, tying Greg Orman, who wasn't independent and really isn't independent on many of his views, but tying him directly to President Obama. The level of dissatisfaction in the state with the way the government is being run, with the state of the nation, is enormous. It is number three for the greatest dissatisfaction at 72%. People are not happy. Still, you say, well, if they're so unhappy, and we spoke to a lot of folks today at many barbecue joints, spending a lot of time talking to folks, what do they say? They want to change. Still, they voted for Pat Roberts by a pretty sizable margin today, larger than anyone expected, I think because they feared the unknown. They feared Greg Orman, and it really had been, it's been since 1932 that a non-Republican has been elected here. They just couldn't get over the historical enormity of voting a non-Republican into office. At the end of the day, people just seem to have voted with what they're comfortable with. And by the way, Dan, that might also happen with the gubernatorial race here. Sam Brownback was really struggling, coming from behind against Paul Davis here. Brownback, the incumbent. Everybody thought he's probably going to lose. It's a very, very tight race as well. So the conservatives in this very, very red state are coming back. They're voting for their leaders, even though they are unhappy with them. A lot of folks said to me, this is the last time. Promise I'm not going to do it again. I just couldn't vote for the other guys. Dan.
Such a fascinating dynamic in that state.